Hey guys, welcome to this Mometrix introduction video to polynomials. So, polynomial comes from poly, which means many, and nomial meaning term. So really, it just says many terms. Polynomials can have exponents like the 4 and x to the 4th. They can have variables like x and y, and they can have constants like 7,000, negative 3 million, 1/4, 1, etc. You can even combine all of these using addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. However, a polynomial can never be divided by a variable, only by a constant. Negative 28 divided by 7x plus 1 is not a polynomial because there's a variable in the denominator. Now we have to be careful and remember all of our algebra tricks. Take a look at this. Negative 28 divided by 7x to the negative 2nd plus 1. Because the exponent in the bottom has a negative exponent, we know that when simplified, the exponent is actually moved to the top, which means that this is a polynomial. Let's look at another example. 290yx to the negative 5th. This is not a polynomial because when simplified, the variable y is moved from the numerator to the denominator because of the negative exponent. And a polynomial cannot have a variable in the denominator. Now try this one. 7xy to the 24th plus 28x minus 7y to the 23rd minus 3. Polynomial or not? This is a polynomial. It does not have a variable in the denominator. Another thing that is important to know is that a polynomial can also have one term. For instance, 5 alone is a polynomial. This may seem confusing given that polynomial actually says many terms, so I just want to make that clear. Polynomials with 1, 2, or 3 terms all have special names. The name for a polynomial with one term is a monomial. A polynomial with 2 terms is a binomial, and a polynomial with 3 terms, as you might guess, is a trinomial. There is also the quadrinomial with 4 terms and the quintinomial with 5 terms, but those are not often used. A polynomial can have as many terms as you need, but it can't have an infinite number of terms, so figure that one out. Polynomials are really great in math because they are easy to work with. If you add polynomials together, you're still left with a polynomial. If you multiply polynomials together, you still have a polynomial. You can divide polynomials, however, the result may not be a polynomial. Also, polynomials with one variable are great for graphing because their lines are always smooth and continuous. The last thing you need to know about a polynomial is the standard way to write a polynomial. The standard way to write a polynomial is in descending order, with the highest degree first, farthest to the left, and the lowest degree last. Degrees in this sense refers to the number in the exponent. So to put the polynomial 7x minus 7 plus 24x to the 3rd plus 1x to the 7th, you would move the term with the highest number in the exponent to the front. In this case, you would move 1x to the 7th to the front, and so on. Once you have completed, the standard form of this polynomial is 1x to the 7th plus 24x to the 3rd plus 7x minus 7. I hope this video helped you to understand polynomials a little better. Be sure to subscribe to our channel right here for more videos. See you next time.